Hello and welcome to another replay cast. Today I'm gonna feature one of my clan members. That's Delert. Maybe some of you can remember he had once, I think it was a good new young game or a Pledger, I can't remember, but I featured him on my channel before. And yeah, this time he's playing Yamato and I had also a pretty exciting game here on Hotspot. He's in division with Yamineko and Magilu, so he has some support, of course. And yeah, I watched the replay before, and I have to say he's playing it quite good. Yamato is considered to be a stationary battleship, more or less. So you are kind of a fort in a position, and you try to, yeah, not locking down, but be a threat to all enemy ships that want to come close to a certain point. So especially in Yamato, you want to be kind of in a central position, never on the flanks. If you are in the Yamato on the flank, normally something bad is happening. You're either like mispositioned completely in the beginning, or yeah, you are forced to. That's the only reasons I can think of why you should be on the flank with a Yamato. The one is forced and the other one is absolutely unnecessary. Okay, so he's moving in this area here, which is quite a good idea. I think I would do it with every battleship in the beginning, but never go here with the Yamato. You just stay in this vicinity here. So if your team decides to go for BC, that you can cover both these areas with your guns, and that's really important. Because with the Yamato, nobody likes to joke with. That's for sure. Even battleships have a lot of respect for Yamato, since they are accurate and they can overmatch all the armors. Unless you're a bit angled. But I think, I'm not sure. No, you can't angle against Yamato shells. I mean, some people say they bounce Yamato shells. It's hard to believe, but it happened actually. yeah, these 460mm shells are really, really nasty. But okay, let's see. Slowly evolving something there. His team is going to go for A and B, while his team is this side is like the C area, but they don't need to enter and just can be the force outside here. That Des Moines never heard of maybe evading. No, he didn't. That's questionable play by the Des Moines there. But it looks as if he would continue like this. Ah, he's angling a bit in. But what he's totally forgetting is that he's shooting all the time, he's spotted all the time, and that means ever, especially he comes to a crucial point, he needs to pass this gap here. So if he's not angled or dark, he's presenting all this broadside, and it looks as if he doesn't care. Nope, he doesn't. And Della tries to capitalize on this, and yeah, now he turns in. That's not a good idea. Yeah, and presents full broadside citadel and gets punished. Yeah, welcome to T10. Some people play as if they are on tier 4, even lower. So yeah, GG, Mr. Des Moines. You are not good at this game, I can tell you. All right, Hindenburg also broadside. I mean, I can understand this. They are pushing down the flank, which is which can result in getting a lot of map control, and on top that are that are cruisers. But yeah, I think the attempt of the Hindenburg is a bit too bold, I would say. Delert is also presenting a bit too much broadside. I think he should angle away now. He's lucky that he doesn't get a citadel. Maybe he was aware that torps are coming, I'm not sure, but this danger is always present, I would say. Especially if you have no radar or DD in this surroundings. Alright, so yeah, that should be the killing blow for the Hindenburg. Yeah, he clearly overextended too much. I mean, I can respect the effort, but nobody of his team helped him, so no point of rushing in. and go out with like 10k damage, because more it can't be. I think people are trying to force too much, always, really too much. So now you see why this position he's in is so valuable, because now he's just going to the middle, relocate, and is, yeah, working on these, what is going into the middle, the two Alsace. So, pretty easy. Yeah, Kurfürst wasn't patient, he could have waited, like, I wouldn't even shot, because there were no clean shots on him. Because he wasn't spotted and he didn't get show broadside. Unless he's stationary and I can shoot the superstructure when he's angled, I wouldn't shoot the Yamato. Or he's showing, of course, a broadside. But otherwise than that, nope. Somehow, Dellert's Z-46 managed to die to a Alsace, which is quite surprising, but okay. You never know. Maybe he was spotted, I'm not sure. And he's presenting a bit too much broadside again. Talking of broadsides, broadside west side, we could also say about this Alsace. But Alsace is absolutely trollish when it comes to armor, in my opinion. I really struggle sometimes with other battleships to inflict a lot of damage. Yeah, then it is going now for the battleship that shows broadside, which is the other Alsace, the other the first one turned away a bit, so the angles aren't that good anymore. Yeah, but 8,000, I mean, this armor is pretty good. Watch out, so to say. Yeah, and the next one should finish the Alsace, or at least the fire seal they had, which are ticking. Yeah, 12k, that's a nasty good volley. So now we can concentrate on the other Alsace. Shouldn't be such a big thing. Even, I think the backup should be enough. Angling not possible against Yamato. Alright, so he's a bit alone now because nobody of the enemy is. Oh no, of non friendly DD is close to B, which is kind of an issue. But still, his team is leading right now, so it doesn't matter too much. So he's not panicking, he is just slowing down, maybe throw off the aim of the torps of some DD that is in B, and working on the Kurfürst. I think Dalit makes one mistake, he's showing a bit too much broadside, but yeah, the enemy doesn't want to punish him, it looks like, so or they tried, or their aim was pretty bad, I'm not sure. Yeah, nice body on the Kurfürst there. Yeah, especially now, he needs to move. I think there's... what is left on the enemy team? I think that's the Des Moines. And Des Moines AP can hurt quite a lot. As we just see. Alright, Kofor is still presenting for broadside. Yeah, broadside best side, as I said, this is... I think you can, like, conclude this. Into the replay, I mean, so much broadside the enemy battleships are showing. Okay, not anymore. Still. These Alsace didn't care. They just sent broadside on. Alright, yeah, Dalet's team is about to lose every map control, which is a kind. Ah, okay, Yamineko and his Minotaur is going into. He now eats a ton of damage. What the hell happened there? Ouchie babachi, this was. I guess that was lucky. Alright, yeah, Dalet will eat a torp, that's for sure. On the nose, probably set 46 torps, so they shouldn't do too much damage. The Des Moines is... the enemy Des Moines is in a really, really bad spot right now. Dada just needs a glimpse on him and needs to be far enough far back to get clean shots on him. Look, he's waiting patiently until he is sure that his shells will make it over the island. I think that's okay-ish volley. Yeah, that was hit in the superstructure, I think, from one of the Kurfürsts. Yeah, that should seal the deal here for the Des Moines, if the volley is kind of precise. Yep, Citadel plunged into the Citadel. Alright, so they have B cap. I think it should be easy for them to get the C cap back. And if the Iowa is smart, he's going into A. And then everyone is applying enough pressure. I think Dallard is retreating a bit to wait for his damage con, then he's healing up, and then he can go in the aggressive mode again. The fact that he spotted tells him that there is a DD close. And yeah, he's continuously in this central position. He has complete shots into everywhere, every direction. And yeah, it's such a big force that the enemy cruisers aren't able to do anything. I don't know why the enemy Kurfürst is going through C now. That sounds or looks rather questionable, in my opinion. Because there's actually no need. Ah, well, okay, maybe he saw the Zao going and then he's trying to block it, that could also be. Zao is going down. Whatever that guy is telling in the chat, I have no clue. One thing I really wouldn't do in a Yamato is bringing a stock fighter plane, not even the premium consumable. I would bring always the spotter plane, just to have this great shots. It's not about the range, it's more about... how can you say it? Yeah, if you have want to have shots in smoke, that's really, really important. Okay, due to the lack of any other target, he's going for the Des Moines. What is it? 20 kilometers? Okay. Well, if the Des Moines doesn't pay attention, there's a good chance, and the dispersion is... that he gets a good strike there. At least a good volley. Looks good so far. Des Moines doesn't... Oh no, he's angling too late. Whoa! What a shot. I mean, I saw that before, but still absolutely amazed. That was 20 kilometers death strike on a almost full HP, Des Moines. Okay, he didn't pay attention, that's true, but yeah. I mean, if you get death strike, then it's normally the case. Also, he's running his Yamamoto captain, which gives him now a really ridiculous reload time. Just check the reload timer. I think it's around 15-14 seconds. Which makes it almost cruiser level. Hilarious. So, Yamamoto with Kraken. Yeah, great. I never achieved that. So, Dallard, I'm envying you. I'm really envying you. And now the game is, yeah, more or less over. Enemy has no control, it's just ripping up the things and hopefully destroy as many ships as possible, and it should be fine. Yeah. 14 second reload, oh my god. 12k, nice volley on the Kurfürst again. The Kurfürst. He did, what I don't understand is why the Kurfürst is still running away. He just needs to angle towards Dallard and then shoot the Zaos. That's all. The only thing he needs to do. Instead, he's like going away. There is no DD threat anymore. So yeah, really questionable. Don't get it. I mean, of course it's punishing even setting bow on, but if there is a battleship that can do it and bounce with the front, then it's the Kurfürst. That's really a ship that is not to laugh at when it comes to armor. You see? Even when, especially when angled and... Yeah, even Yamato isn't able to pen him nasty. There he turned a bit too much in the way. Z46 is spotted for whatever reasons. Don't know if Yami is smoking. I think he smokes. Don't know why he is spotted. Maybe from a plane or something. Nice volley. Now I don't get why the Z46 is shooting. That is really questionable. I mean, if I would be DD, I would like torp them to shit, that's it. Deadhead Steam doesn't even have any radar ships anymore. No. No DDs, no radar ships, so it should be the paradise for... yeah, for the enemy DDs, in my opinion. But no, they get spotted, they shoot, and die unnecessary. That's a thick skill, pretty strong play here by him, and yeah, that's exactly... yeah, how you are supposed to play Yamato. Be a constant threat, tank for your team, retreat if you need to take a break from tanking, going in again, and yeah, get like devastating shots out. That's it. And you don't have to fear any battleship. If you angle and your team is backing you up, then nothing can happen to you. And that's what exactly happened here. Alright, yeah. Nice 225. What, 223, 4k damage isn't so irrelevant. I'm normally featuring only games where, of course, it's a bit exciting, but you also can learn something from. And this Yamato game showed exactly how you should play the Yamato. A lot of people tend to overextend in the Yamato, which means they are going too offensive in the beginning, especially in the beginning, and then they get burnt down and die within seconds. Now, Yamato has so precise guns, it can stay a bit back. Don't stay too far back. You have still to tank for your team, but yeah, definitely don't go too close, because then that can end you quite fast as well. Especially in crossfire situations, the Yamato is really, really bad at. Alright, so 6 kills, 5 citadels, Kraken, Confederate, Dreadnought, I think it was First Blood as well, and High Caliber. So you got all the good stuff, and also activated Yamamoto's specials, so to say. So to speak, I heard a while ago, so I'm sorry if I always messed that up, but yeah, so to speak. Alright, 3125 base XP, not too bad, I would say. I mean, considering the tiers... Yeah, it was only tier 9, tier 10 game, yeah, then it's quite respectable, I would say. I mean, it would be even more respectable if the other ones would be only tier 8s, but then he would have probably killed 3 DDs and whatever. But yeah, 3125, really, really nice result. Yeah, good play there. And yeah, I mean, detailed... That Des Moines absolutely potatoing. That Des Moines didn't take or didn't count in that he can be shot at from 20 kilometers and also died. But this was pure potatoing, this was a bit unlucky or maybe just a bit unconsciousness. Oh wow, they had 3 Des Moines. That guy also died. Yeah, well, he played. Yeah. He was lost in his position. That guy pushed too far. Alsace, yeah, well, not we need don't need to talk about that. They weren't too smart either. They just rushed the middle broadside on. Not the best choice. Potential damage 2.8. No, I think that's quite okay. 3 million, 3.5 would be better, but I think he had his share of tanking there, so nothing to worry about. Yeah, that's basically it. All right, hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have questions towards the replay or anything else, then just write it down in the section below and or in the comments below. And if you liked it, just give it a like. This is much appreciated. Otherwise, wish you a good start in the week and see you next time. Bye bye.